Hello, 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 and welcome to another Rang Rouge unit of the Reek. Now, before we get started, this is a rather important episode, because we are episode 104 Reeks. Now, in terms of years, that is exactly 2 years worth of unit of the Reek, which is, well, that's a lot of units. I mean, if we go statistically, by wargame number standards, we've probably covered roughly 5 to 8% of the units exactly, depends on if you count duplicates and different variations and so. But anyway, I really just want to say thank you very much. Thanks for sticking around this long, watching my videos and giving me the support. I definitely appreciate it. I mean, 2 years is a long bloody time to be doing such a series like this, but thanks, it honestly means an awful lot to me. And so, this Reek's unit is all about supply trucks. So, trucks themselves have been used in warfare really since World War One, because by the time automobile came around, some people said, hey, it'd be cool if we could have a bigger version of this that could carry a lot of things. And so, trucks came into existence. And they made a lot of sense in World War One compared to horse-drawn carriages, even though horses were the main transport for a lot of armies back then. A truck doesn't need to be fed, it doesn't need a vet to look after it, only a mechanic, only really needs one person to man said truck, and it can carry more as well as go a lot faster. A rather common truck that was used during the First World War was a Liberty truck, and made by the Americans of all people. And so, trucks came into use. You started seeing some mechanized brigades during the interwar period, and then World War II came around, and trucks played a rather vital role in supplying the armies. The Americans, under the Lend-Lease program, would donate hundreds of thousands of trucks to the Soviets to help supply the Eastern Front. From D-Day, trucks were going back and forth off Normandy Beach constantly to resupply troops in mainland France. Trucks have been very, very important even after World War II, where most infantry divisions by that point were mechanized, because it's a lot faster to all jump in a truck than to walk to and from the battlefield. And simply put, ever since then, trucks have just gotten more bigger and a bit more faster. If we look at now at the heavy expanded mobility tactical truck, or the Hemet, that thing can carry roughly 10 tons worth of stuff, and, well, that's a lot of stuff. And trucks, they carry stuff to and from, simply put. Now, in-game, trucks usually cost from 10 to 40 points, and they're available to pretty much every single country. Surprise, surprise, none of the trucks have any weapons whatsoever. So really, it's all about their miscellaneous stats. And they all really follow the same trends in this regard. No armor whatsoever. Usually 5 HP for the cheaper trucks and 10 HP for the bigger and badder ones. Most of them have an off-road speed of 50 to 80 kilometers an hour and 150 on-road, except for the AMX and MTLB, because they are technically APCs and not trucks. They can pretty much be brought up in any type of deck whatsoever, and of course, the more expensive the truck, the more supply you get in it. Now, what I do find rather interesting is that if you multiply the amount of trucks you get by the amount of supply that each truck's owed to get the total of how much supply you get per card, the results are really kind of crazy, because 10-point trucks only get 7,000 supply per card, or the 40-point trucks get a whopping 12,000, almost double. Now, you are paying more, because, for example, the 10-point, you're paying 140 to buy all those trucks. But with the 40-point, you're paying a whopping 200 to buy all those trucks. But in a 1v1 scenario where you don't have an FOB and you need supply, it's honestly 95% of the time always a smart idea to get the most expensive trucks in your deck, because you don't have to resupply them as much, and you get more supply, more bang for your buck. Now, in battle, supply trucks are absolutely essential if you want to have a shot at winning any match. The second most important unit behind your command vehicle, because your frontline units, your AA, need ammunition so they can keep shooting down aircraft. Your infantry are going to get hit up quite a bit, and same with your super heavy tanks after they take a few ATGMs to the face. So Renio's convoy of trucks crest over the hill, filled with goodies, mainly repair parts, fuel, and ammunition, your frontline units will thank you for it. But simply put, they're essential. You need these guys. They're super, super, super useful. Now you may think, oh, I could get away with using supply helicopters. Heck, they're faster. They can get back and forth on the FOB a lot quicker. The downside is they're easily exposable. You cannot hide them in a forest. And all supply vehicles are extremely weak. And they also make a rather big explosion when they blow up. So try to micromanage them away from each other. So if one dies, the rest of the pack doesn't die. But supply trucks, you need them. Just have them in your deck. If you don't have them in your deck, add them. Go back and add them now. Try to get the more expensive runs, of course. So I'm going to shut up and leave it at that. Once again, I want to say thank you very much for sticking around with this series for so long. And as usual, please just take it easy.